Stop getting the wrong advice. Ensure you get the right skills for the right job for jobs in the Middle East. Contact Loy Macedo.
All right. So now this is the second question that was that one of my viewers asked me. Now, this is in relation to career and kind of a midlife crisis. Okay? So this one is, hi Loy, hope you're doing well. I saw your videos regularly from the last 3 to 4 years. I really like your thoughts about UAE. I came here in 2016 and the job market is not so good since that time. And after COVID, it just got worse. Expenses have increased. But I'd like to share with you about myself. Now, before I even move forward, I want to tell you that you need to change your mindset, okay? It's very important to change your mindset. The market situation has gotten worse. Yes, it has gotten worse, but it has not gotten worse for everyone. There are people who are still making money. There are people who are very successful. There are people who, the billionaires, they have made more money during this pandemic. Now, I'm not trying to give you some motivational, inspirational talk and all that bullshit. See, whether the market is good or whether the market is bad, you focus on you. You don't give a damn about what people are saying or what the market is. See, like, I'll give a small example now. For example, me. Whether the market is good, whether the market is bad. Fuck, is that a cobra? Oh, that's a leaf. I'll show you. You can see there. It looked like a cobra. It was standing like this. Anyway. So, whether the market is good or whether the market is bad, I have to provide for my family. I have to earn money. I can't... Who will I give excuses? I don't have friends. I don't have family. I thought this was a cobra. From far it was. Anyway. There are snakes here, by the way. So, see, whether the market is good or bad, I have to earn money. I have to provide, take care of my wife and kid. I can't go around telling, oh shit, market is good, market. Nobody will give a fuck. And anyway, I don't have family members. So, I'm not trying to lecture you, but I'm trying to tell you, change your mindset. Okay, oh, I came here, then the market went bad. Oh, expenses are high. Expenses will always be high. Market will always be bad. So, you focus on earning more. And for that, the first thing is your mindset. Okay, next one. I'm a normal graduate from Delhi University with no professional degree. Now, that in itself is a major drawback, especially in the corporate world. If you don't have a degree, you'll not be offered a leadership position in a typical corporate structure. If it's a local company or if it's a privately owned, they might ignore it. But if it's a multinational company or a government organization or semi-government, it's impossible for you to climb up, especially with this. I'm 37 years old. Well, you're getting into the midlife crisis of 40, and that's a very dangerous zone, because once you reach 40, either make sure that you get the maximum salary and you keep pushing, because after 45 or 50 is decline, by the way. After 50 only decline, unless you're some Satya Nandala or something. Otherwise, after 40, it's not going to climb up anymore. So take it with a sense of urgency. 37 is a very dangerous phase in your life, you know. That's why when you ask someone, how old is he? 40. Oh, 40. They go like, he's old, you know. Before coming to UAE, I was working in Delhi and my salary was 35,000 rupees per month. I have my own 2-bedroom apartment in Delhi. Very good, smart investment. So you don't have to worry about going back home and not having a place to stay. When I came to Dubai, my first salary was 2,000 dirhams and today it's 10,000. Again, once again, very good. I think from 2,000 to 10,000, you have increased your income 5 times. So I just hope your savings also 5 times more. Okay, then, not a party guy, no booze, no cigarettes. Fantastic. That speaks highly about you as an individual. This in itself shows that you'll make smarter decisions. Now, my wife is also living with me for the last 6 months. She better take up a job, otherwise it's going to get very expensive. I used to save 1,000 dirhams every month. This doesn't make sense, because when you are earning 2,000, what were you saving? Okay, 2,000 maybe you can't save anything. But then, now you're earning 10,000. I think you need to cut down on your expense and your lifestyle. At least that's my opinion. Otherwise, why are you working in UAE, man? Because if you leave UAE and go back to India, they're not going to recognize the work experience unless, of course, you're exceptional. So what are you going to do? You better start focusing on savings. Like I tell people, even if you get 100,000 dirhams, but your savings are zero, it's pointless. But it's impossible to save more than that. I wouldn't say it's impossible, but depending on your lifestyle, it can be possible or impossible. I want to save at least 25% of my earnings, but for now it's okay. I don't think if I was in Delhi, I'd be able to double my salary, at least not in the 6 years, which is very true. India is a very tough market. It's very competitive. My colleagues who are working with me in Delhi are in the same job. Most of them are still earning 50,000 rupees, but you have two guys who have reached 60 to 65. See, India, they'll earn as per Indian standards. When you go abroad, you earn as per standards abroad. But at the same time, you also have to spend accordingly, you know. That's a tough part. They have their own flats, but somehow managing. I would like to request you please make a video addressing on the subject. Because there are thousands of people from India or Pakistan, and they just want to go to Dubai. They have professional qualifications, okay. I've seen many on your many comments on your video. The comments, Loy, are so negative about UAE, but this is the hardcore reality. But I still believe there are examples like me. I'm happy here, enjoying my life. See, now, before I read further, you have asked me to, make a video on the subject of savings. See, there are too many variables to speak about here. One is, are you single? Are you married? Then second one is, do you have 2 family members, 4 family members, 6 family members? Then do your family members, are they demanding? Are they simple? Are your children big or small? Do you live a simple life and do nothing after you come back from office? Or do you exercise? Do you go out? Do you want to live a happy life? Do you want to live an average life? There are so many variables. It is impossible to give one standard answer for everyone. But I can just give you my perspective. The biggest reason why I left UAE was because I was reaching the same age that you are reaching. When I was 37, I was like, what the fuck am I doing? How much am I saving? And I realized, even if I earn 100,000 and I don't save anything, it's useless. So that is why I made a transition to come to here, because that time VAT was just going to be introduced. So in UAE, if I would stay there, say if I was really just average, I would save like you 10%. If I was strict, 20%. But then I didn't have the motivation to save more. However, today, when I am here, the same example if I give, in UAE I was saving 10%. Here easily I can save 40%. In UAE, if I was really strict, I could save 30 or 40. Here, if I'm really strict, I can save 70 or 80% of my income. So the point I'm trying to tell you is, you need to make the smart decisions. Now, that doesn't mean every Indian, Pakistani, Sri Lankan can come running to Thailand or Philippines or third world countries. look at my career path, look at my personality, look at my earning system. I'm a YouTuber, I have tattoos, I know how to talk, I know how to sell, I don't work for a company. Can you do all that? So then you come here, you'll take up a job. They'll pay you in Thai salaries. And if you get a Thai salary, you'll save the same that you're saving in India. So keep this in mind, people are different. So one size fits all, you cannot have one answer. Then, I still believe I'm happy enjoying my life here. Yeah, you're enjoying for now. Once you lose your job, you'll not be enjoying anymore. And then after 40, if you're not earning 15,000 or something, you're earning 10. You need to focus on earning 15. This is pointless, man. Also, I want to know if you can give me advice. My parents want me to come back to India and live with them. Parents are emotional. Parents always, they talk of love, beta, God, and that all is bullshit. See, I understand parents are important and we need to cater to their emotions and feelings. But the world doesn't run on emotions and feelings. You need to look at your earning capacity. So let your parents say whatever the fuck they want. Don't fall for all this bullshit. I know so many cases where parents have cried and moaned and this and that, and the girl or the guy has got married to the wrong person or changed their career or done something stupid. And I'll tell you, the life has been a disaster. Then the parents eventually grow old and die, and then you're left to bear the decision that you took on behalf of them. They have another few more years to live, so you don't destroy your entire life making a decision, you know, to keep them happy. I know this sounds cruel, but you can't blame anyone if tomorrow you take a decision based on their feelings and it turns out to be a mistake. So take personal responsibility. And I'm not in a position to bring my parents to Dubai and live with them, because then I cannot handle my expenses. Then don't get them. Just pay them money, tell them this is life. This is a reality. If I come to India, I don't have any way forward. Unless, of course, they're giving you millions of dollars worth of property and jaidad and all that stuff. Then go and kiss their ass and whatever. Otherwise, just keep put. One of my friends has moved to Canada 2 years ago. He was in Dubai for the last 10 years. He's asking me to come to Canada. If you have to go to Canada, go before 40. But remember, once you go to Canada, your friend is not going to help you. Your friend is not going to take care of you. You have to take care of yourself. And when your friend left to Canada, it was a different time, a different phase of life. If you go to Canada, it's a different phase of life. Your friend's skills are different, your skills are different. Your friend's personality is different, your personality is different. Your friend operated on a different environment, you're operating on a different environment. So just keep in mind, whatever decision you take, end of the day, you'll have to live with the consequences. Then let me know your thoughts when you're free, and if you can make a video on this topic without taking my name. See, bottom line, I'll tell you, focus on money. Right now, your earning capacity is absolutely terrible. Terrible, terrible is an understatement. Your earning per month, what some people are earning per day. I'm not exaggerating. I'm not trying to make you feel bad. This is a reality. And these people who are earning that kind of money are not millionaires or billionaires. They're normal people. So I just feel you're in your comfort zone because you are earning 2,000 to 10,000. Now you feel, wow, because you have a stable job. But a mindset like the one you have, including the salary structure that you're getting, your career path, maximum I see you climbing to 12,000, and there you'll be stuck. 15 is too far-fetched, because you need really some solid skills. You really need to shake things up. But if in case you get 15, yes, if you get it before 40, 45, you get 15, you can push for 20. If on the other hand, you get just 10 to 12, maximum 13, 14, you can get a 15. But what happens as you become older, the younger generation will come and you will get more competition and it becomes harder, man. So I just personally feel you're in your comfort zone. You're taking life easy. Like you said, you're happy. And I just feel you are headed for trouble, because if you lose your job, then you're fucked. And then, you know, parents, and if your parents are old, remember, you'll have to go take care of them, treatment, this, that. There's so many other factors into play. So yeah, I would just say that you and your wife have to work together to save more money. You have to get a better paying job, at least 50% more. And better take some drastic steps, because it sounds to me you're just in your comfort zone and wishful thinking. And this one that you sent me, just wanted a chuma opinion. But I don't think you're serious about life. You don't have a strategy. That's my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. Let me know your thoughts, comments down below. Don't hate on the guy. And yeah, do support the channel if you can. Like how I support you guys. Appreciate any of this YouTube's algorithm. Like, share, subscribe, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Okay, you guys take care. Any questions, send it to me. If I find it interesting, I'll make a video. Chalo.